Welcome back to my channel. Students, today we are going to do the 100 dresses part 1. I have divided part 1 into two parts. This is part A. I have deleted the unnecessary dialogue bits which are not necessary for the exam. And here I am giving an explanation completely based on the exam point of view. And you will not miss out on the story as well. Theme. Here the theme of the 100 dresses part 1 is about discrimination against the poor, against class difference. There is a poor girl called Wanda Petronsky and she is harassed and ragged because she is poor. She also has a different name, different from other American children. Though Wanda does not express her feelings, she is affected by the bullying and feels isolated. Here the author wants to tell us that the children or anybody, the victim may not express herself, yet she understands and she feels bad about it. First we'll talk about Wanda. Wanda sat in the seat next to the last seat, last row in room 13. The class room number was 13. She sat all alone. She sat in a corner where boys who didn't score marks sat. So she sat with those children who didn't study or who were not interested in study. She sat where there was most scuffling of feet, roars of laughter, most mud and dirt on the floor. Scuffling means shifting. When you keep on shifting your feet, you make a noise. So these children used to make a noise unnecessarily and they used to keep laughing at everything in order to disturb the class. Peggy and Maddie made fun of her. Wanda was very quiet and rarely said anything at all. She twisted her mouth into a crooked smile and she lived in Boogin Heights. Boogin Heights was a place where the poor lived. And if anyone lived in Boogin Heights, people would know that they were not well-to-do. Her feet were usually caked with dry mud because she was doing so much of walking coming to school that naturally her shoes were getting dirty and muddy. No one really thought much about Wanda Petronsky. Her name was different from the names of other students. Wanda didn't have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. None of the students were even interested in being her friend. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang well. It was clean, but it was never ironed. Sometimes she stood watching other girls play hopscotch. Watching is seeing. So here we see that Wanda was completely lonely. Nobody was interested in her. She was a character who could be easily forgotten. She wore a faded dress. She just kept quiet. Her name was also different. Peggy. Peggy was the direct contrast of Wanda. Peggy was the most popular girl in school. She was pretty. She had many pretty clothes. Her hair was curly and beautiful. Peggy made fun of Wanda. But Peggy was not cruel. This is because she protected small children from bullies. She also cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. Then how and why did she rag Wanda? She ragged Wanda because she felt that Wanda was telling them lies by saying that she had 100 dresses, and that is why she deserved to be bullied. Maddie. Maddie was a follower of Peggy and a friend of hers. Maddie herself was a poor girl. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Hand-me-down clothes means second-hand clothes worn by some rich person and then just given away as charity to Maddie. She was grateful that she didn't live on Boogin Heights or have a funny name. Grateful, thankful. So she was happy. At least people didn't know that she was poor, nor was she different from the other children in America over there. Being poor herself, she was uncomfortable when Peggy asked Wanda how many dresses Wanda had. Though Maddie was poor, she didn't appear poor. She felt uncomfortable when Peggy asked Wanda how many dresses Wanda had, because Maddie herself didn't have many dresses. Maddie pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the other girls. Peggy might ask her where she got the dresses from. Maddie wore Peggy's old clothes. This was her constant fear, Maddie's fear. She imagined that Peggy and the other girls would make fun of her the way they made fun of Wanda. They would ask her where she got her dresses from. In fact, Maddie's dresses were all Peggy's old dresses, which Maddie's mother very cleverly hid the identity. She made laces somewhere. She put trimmings in other places. So the whole dress looked very different from Peggy's dress. She often wanted to tell Peggy to stop teasing Wanda, but feared losing Peggy's friendship. So though she was against teasing Wanda, she still stood with Peggy when Peggy was teasing Wanda. She also consoled herself by saying that Wanda was someone she didn't know. And if anybody asked her, she would not be foolish like Wanda and tell people that she had 100 dresses. We will be continuing with part 2. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, and if there is any doubt, please contact me.